I'm Gary Luter. I do theater sometimes, most of the time. I've been doing it here at the University of Tampa for 46 years.
My name is Brooke Paternostro. I am a musical theater major and I am a senior.
Oh no, I thought you said you want me to go first.
No, yeah, you can go first.
No, you can go first.
My name is Robert Logan Mays. I'm currently a sophomore here at the University of Tampa. I'm a theater major and yeah.
My name is Nikki Kanata. I'm a senior and I'm a speech and communications major with a business administration minor.
Hello, I am Parker Greenblatt. I am a musical theater major and I'm also a sophomore here at the University of Tampa.
There's eight separate stories in Almost Maine. I see it as a fable. And the people who populate Almost Maine, they're presenting their fables for the world to observe. And almost all of them have to do with the magic of love.
Go for it. I am in two scenes. I am in scene two, Sad and Glad, which is about this guy named Jimmy, who is a complete loser. And he runs into his ex-fiance and they have a whole like thing, discussion, and then he ends up finding a new love after kind of finally letting go of his past one. And the other scene I am in, which is scene five, is called They Fell. And it's kind of a story of like forbidden love and kind of like finally like letting go and learning your true self.
I am in scene four, which is called Getting It Back. I play Gail. And she's been in a relationship for 11 years, and her boyfriend, Lendl, won't propose to her. So she goes to his house in the middle of the night with all of the stuff he's ever given her. And she's like, here's everything you've given me. I want all the love that I gave you back so I can move on. But then he ends up proposing.
I really like the scene that I have, it's like scene three. I probably wouldn't have been able to do scene eight. I would be too awkward for that scene.
I am in scene eight called Seeing the Thing. It's about two really close friends who, there's something more there. And Rhonda, she doesn't realize it, but Dave knows. And he paints her this picture and she doesn't know what it is. So the whole through line of the play is Dave trying to admit his feelings to Rhonda and get her to understand where he's coming from and hopefully have her return the feelings as well.
I realized our two scenes are very similar.
They are.
They fell and it's very similar.
Yeah.
I had around 40 people audition. And the ones who were quirky and odd, I cast them.
No reason. There's no way it was worse than mine.
Yeah!
Really?
I can't feel pain.
What? What things? There aren't any things in this town to get away from.
And you mess with it! And you don't do that!
I'm here longer than I said I'd be.
Oh!
Ow!
No.
What I tell the actors is, because I block them, and sometimes I give them some ideas, they have to make those their own. They cannot be up there executing gestures or movements or line readings or internal intentions that they were fed to by a director. They have to own it. They have to own what they do.
She can't be looking at it because Sophie's going to hit her in the face. Can you be looking in one of his books?
Oh, true.
I think that when I auditioned for the role of Gail, and throughout the callback and the whole beginning of the process, I pictured her as a very like sweet and caring person who is very emotional and like really loves Lendl. But through the process, Luter has helped me to be a lot stronger. He suggested that I take her in a more like angry and sad and crazy direction, so that pushed me out of my comfort zone a lot.
Well, I don't want it. What am I supposed to do with all of it now that I don't want it?
Well, I don't know.
Well, under the circumstances,
you know what
it
circumstances?
Doesn't seem
Gail,
right
what are,
for me.
I don't understand.
To keep it,
what,
so I'm Gail. Going to give it back.
For me, it was kind of similar, but for a lot of my scenes, I feel like Dr. Luter had a very certain idea in mind for what he wanted for all of it. And so it was more or less kind of like him, like being yeah, here's kind of the idea that I want, and then like, as an actor, kind of growing to that and finding my own way organically to his overall idea.
I think you have to make something of that you dancing. There's something about the you that needs to be pulled out of that sentence, Chad.
Mm-hmm.
You dancing? It's like, what, you dancing? I can't believe it.
The difference I've seen between film acting and theater acting is that film is a lot choppier and you have to continually like get yourself back into the moment over and over and over again, and you could do the same line 10 times. Whereas with a play, like doing theater, you get the whole scene, so you get to feel all of the emotions all the way through, which is something that I didn't realize I would like.
Figure out what to do with... Oh, I know. It's that cross, when Lendl leaves, you go Lendl, Lendl, and then you have to go all the way to the chair and sit down and open the bag that has your ring in it.
Yeah.
I think you have to, you went to the chair like you had, like you were gonna sit in it, and you don't know what to do with yourself.
Okay.
So you're wandering around and there's the chair. It all has to do with that wailing that we talked about, you know? Because, you know, and the wailing can go on and on and on. I think you need to lengthen it.
Okay.
And the wail will take you into this point of confusion. What do I do with myself? I'll sit down. And then once you sit down, you don't know what to do. And then you think, what the fuck is this? And you open it up.
I'm Natalie Lloyd. I'm a psych major with a art therapy and sociology double minor. I am a sophomore.
She sits beside me. I bounce off ideas. I need reinforcement. I guess I'm so, what's the word? Not vulnerable. I'm so needy, emotionally needy, that I would turn to Natalie. Is this working, Natalie? What do you think, Natalie? And she was very honest with me. So she was a great help, and I asked her for ideas for blocking and staging. And she took notes, she was on book, she's calling the cues. We cannot get along without a stage manager, and she's very competent. And I believe this is her first time stage managing at the University of Tampa, or perhaps anywhere. So kudos to Natalie Lloyd. She was indispensable.
Oh.
Do you have a pair of scissors by any chance? I'm going to put some double-sided tape
drawers
on that tablecloth so it doesn't fall off the table again.
Oh, wait,
Rich,
what
do I do?
There's things that can hurt you both. Meanwhile, the woman has put the iron back where it belongs. She then goes to the ironing board, folds it up, and turns to put it back where it belongs. As she turns, she accidentally whops the man in the head with the flat face of the ironing board, knocking him off the bench.
To help Dr. Luter, I basically do everything that he doesn't really want to do, and basically the biggest thing is just like making sure everything behind the scenes goes good, like calling all the cues and making sure the actors have everything they need. During the rehearsal process, I was kind of giving an audience perspective for him when he was directing and just like giving a second opinion for everything.
I think that there's a certain level of, I guess, closeness and intimacy that you need for a show like this, and the black box is the perfect space for it.
Mm-hmm.
And it allowed our director, Dr. Luter, to actually be super creative and go with the direction that he wanted with our, we have a bunch of background projections that we're using through the show.
Yeah.
And it's stuff that just wouldn't be possible in the Falk Theater. And I think it gives it that nice feeling of almost Maine.
Mm-hmm. I feel like being able to perform in the black box, like you said, it's very, very intimate, and you can be a lot more subtle with how you act. It's very similar, kind of like acting for like a camera or something like that.
I like the intimacy of a small space, and I think with all these little duet scenes, and they're intimate scenes about people falling in and out of love and discovering love, that intimacy works well in a small space. I don't think it would work so well at the Falk Theater.
I like it a lot better that we're in the black box, just because it's more like intimate, and I feel like all the crowd's reactions are a lot better, and for you guys mainly, to be right there in front of them.
I don't know. I think what I've enjoyed most about watching everyone else's scenes is the work that people have put into it, because I guess since I haven't seen it at the beginning of the process, I'm seeing like the finished scenes. I'm just so impressed with the actors' choices and their relationships with each other and the way that everyone has their own interpretation on the scene. Like, I've seen Almost Maine before, but I've never seen it this way before.
It's really cool to kind of just finally see everybody and see all the hard work and like just see how talented everyone is. It's also cool to kind of just like be able to come together as a cast and kind of like, this is what we have, this is our work and stuff.
Yeah, no, it's awesome to see the talent, like the caliber of talent that we have in this cast. And a lot of us are underclassmen too, so we've got, I can't wait to see what happens with this cast.
It'll be cool.
And what they do in the future. But it was great to see how all the scenes unfold. And especially with the character choices and the different directions that our fellow actors took throughout the process. It's really cool.
Yeah.
Everyone else's scenes were so much better than I could have thought. Like, I feel like everyone fits their role so well, especially like Brooke in her role. I feel like she just suits that role so well, and just everyone.
I think when there are butts in the seats, that it gives them some adrenaline. And I think now, you know, this is the day of our dress rehearsal, final dress rehearsal, and we open tomorrow. I think they're ready for an audience. I think that's the boost they need.
I feel excited, but I think that because we've been rehearsing since January, I feel just like a lot of pressure to like really put it all out there on stage and do a good job. But also I feel excited, of course, and a little emotional because it's my last UT production before I graduate.
Great. Can't wait.
I want to do it. I want to get it done.
Yes.
You know, perform. It'll be fun. It'll be fun to get an audience.
I just can't wait to do it in front of an audience.
Yeah.
That'll be so much fun.
Yeah. Because it's cool now that we have like costumes and our, like, our set and stuff like that. It's like, oh, we're so close. I mean, I'm chomping at the bit.
Yeah.
You know?
Their lives are simple. They're hardworking people. They're plain-spoken people. They work with their hands. They have their feet on the ground. And they fall in love.
I feel like it's about it's about people, and it's about connection between people. Because all of the scenes are all about either new love forming or old love kind of going away. And falling apart.
Yeah. I'd say ultimately it's about magical realism.
Yeah.
And how you've got so many different things going on
inside
of this town of Almost
that
they all connect some way.
It's all woven together.
It's all woven together and it's all highlighted by the Aurora Borealis, and it's magical.
Yeah.
I think that when Dr. Luter said it's about magical moments, I think that that's what I think it's about the most, because all of these like magical things are happening at the same time in the same place with the Northern Lights. So I think it's about like the magic of like love and also like the magic of heartbreak. I don't know, I think there's beauty in both.